I want to take everybody to one place right now.
Where are we going?
Pulse of Steeler Nation.
Oh, man.
It's the only way to start today.
It is.
It's the only way to start today. Steelers take care of the Jets. 37-15. Sunday night football. The whole country watched it. Let's check in with our buddy Nate, the crazy Italian guy, and let's see how he was reacting after the victory last night. Pulse of Steeler Nation.
That's what you call a team effort. Hell yeah, special teams. Beanie Bishop rules.
Oh.
Russell Wilson just had to knock a little rust off, but he is going to be one smooth
operator. Oh, my.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Wow. He's one of one, man. Nate the Crazy Town Guy's one of one, man.
Yelling so loud.
He's so loud. So loud after the game last night. So it's like, you know, whatever, 11:30 midnight, and he's just yelling about the Steelers. That was
smooth
awesome, man.
Smooth operator.
I know, man. Russ is the smooth operator now. Dude, he's going to call Russell Wilson the smooth operator for the rest of the season.
He
now
is.
You know that,
he
right?
Is. 100%.
Man, that was awesome. That was, yeah. That was, you yeah. know, like, it was a little sketchy at the beginning there, and he was like, okay, well, not what's Russell Wilson doing here. You know, he's not that.
Can't make a throw.
And then all of a sudden it just, man, oh boy, this team, man, they got it done. It's Tomlin's favorite. It's all three phases, offense, defense, special teams. So today on the show, Steelers Facebook comments, we'll get to a round of those around 8:55. Even though they won, even though they're looking real good right now,
yeah.
We'll get to the Steelers' Facebook comments, see what they're all about. And Monday Night Football, not tonight, but next week, will be the Steelers' next game. They play the crappy New York Giants, which is scary.
Trap game for the Steelers.
Always trap games, always. Man. Always trap games. So we will have two chances for you this morning to try to get some Steelers-Giants Monday Night Football tickets. That's coming up around 7:30 and 9:30. A lot of Steelers today. It is the Kiss Morning Pre-Show. All right, you want to hear it again?
That's what you call a team effort.
Oh, yeah.
Hell yeah, special teams.
Yep.
Beanie Bishop rules.
Beanie.
Russell Wilson just had to knock a little rust off, but he is going to be one smooth operator.
Oh, man. Yes. And then right into the Steelers.
Steelers!
It's perfect. 10 out of 10, no notes. Hey, I told everybody.
You did?
Yeah, I told everybody. I told everybody back at Steelers training camp, the Steeler to watch out for was Beanie Bishop.
You did. That
he was
you
an
did.
Undrafted rookie out of West Virginia, and I said, hey, why don't you keep one Steeler to watch?
Keep an eye on him.
All you Steelers insiders, feel my power.
Keep an eye on him.
I told you to watch him. Okay? I told you to watch him.
Better watch him.
Now look what happens. Dude, Beanie Bishop picks off future Hall of Famer Aaron Rodgers twice.
Twice.
Almost scores on one. Here was Beanie Bishop after the game about his interceptions.
He's a Hall of Fame quarterback. Got a lot of respect for that guy. And just to be able to get not one, but two of them off of him is crazy.
Oh, man, Beanie Bishop. That's my guy, man. I might buy a Beanie Bishop jersey.
Wow.
That's a lie.
I would not.
I don't even think I can get. Can you get tall jerseys? I don't even know if I can get.
That I don't know.
Beanie Bishop's going to have to give me one of. No, that won't
that
fit
won't
me.
That won't fit you either. Yeah.
All right, Beanie Bishop's going to have to get one of his jerseys made like Cam Hayward. No. Pat Fryer. Who's
maybe
my body
the
more?
The closest will be Muth, probably. Darnell Washington.
Oh, Jesus, God, Darnell Washington's arms are the size of my thighs, Bob. No, I think Freiermuth. Okay, Darnell Washington's height, but, yeah, whose body do I have? I have the muscular build of a 14-year-old boy. All right, well, either way, I like Beanie Bishop a lot. He was my guy in
he
training
was your
camp.
Guy to watch.
Who was your player to watch in training camp,
I think
man?
It was Fatanu.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Man, we're not really watching him
he
too
went man
much.
Down.
Yeah. All right. Well, that's okay. I told everybody watch him. Two interceptions. Man, this defense. Dude, one of my favorite parts of the game. Oh, my gosh. I was laying in bed laughing to myself That's how this Steeler game tickled me. When they blocked that kick.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the, everybody from special teams is running over to Danny Smith, and he's just got a big ball full of gum and just...
Everybody's surrounding him.
And everybody's like smacking Danny. And he's just chewing on gum. Dude, I was laying in my bed by myself watching the game, and I started laughing. Like I was drunk off Yinzer Parr. Oh, man, that was a fun little game, man. Fun little game. Hey, Russ cooked a little bit, huh?
He did. He did.
Tomlin kind of got that one right, maybe, right? Like, for this week?
It looked good.
If Russ doesn't play good, Tomlin is catching hell today.
Nodge looked good.
I know.
Russ just feeding George Pickens looked good. It looked nice, right?
I know. All right, let's hear from Russell Wilson after the Steelers, of course, beat the Jets 37-15. Russell Wilson threw for 264 yards, two touchdowns, no interceptions. He even had a one-yard touchdown run. It was just good.
It was good.
What do we need for? We need the final countdown tango version to play behind Russell Wilson, right?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Now this is weird because I remember we had a different song. We did the Crazy Frog song for Justin Fields, so we also have to switch our starting quarterback post game interview music. Here is Russell Wilson just talking about how he felt.
You know, I felt like it was playoff baseball. I said out there, I started off 0-2.
Yeah, we don't know about playoff baseball here, Russ. We don't know what that means, damn it!
I felt like, I was going to get hot. I kept telling Coach, hey, I'm going to get hot here. And sure enough, we did. We did a great job. The guys did a tremendous job up front, giving me enough time to make throws. Guys made plays down the field and everything else. And I think it's just the love of the game. You know, I played so many games, and you know that every game's different. Every game has its own story.
Yeah.
And every game has different moments in it.
Yeah.
And you catch the wave. And once you find it, you don't let go. And I think the biggest thing is just knowing who you are.
No, he should have stopped it. We caught the wave already, Russ. He told us we caught the wave. He should have stopped talking there, right? All right, hold on.
Knowing the belief you have in yourself and knowing that was my first time back. And I was like, okay, I'm starting to feel it again. Here we go. It's been a while. Yeah. It's just been 6 weeks from really playing.
Like riding a bike.
And I'm just grateful for my teammates, man. These guys did so much. They did so well.
Heck yeah.
Defense was lights out.
I forgot.
He's just up there telling story. Like, hey, what are we doing?
I forgot what the initial question was. I seriously did.
No clue at all.
I forgot what he was even asked. He's been just going on. All right. Here is Russell Wilson. This is a shorter answer. He was just asked, when did he feel out there like, oh, he was back, the Russ is back?
I think throwing that first touchdown on George was the moment I was like, all right, there's going to be a lot more of these, I believe. You know, sometimes it takes that first home run, that first, double off the wall, whatever it may be.
My guy loves baseball,
baseball,
man. He loves it.
Obviously, it's October, so I'm talking baseball. But
don't know about October baseball in this city,
don't
Russ.
Don't even get to sniff it.
You got
to
stop with the baseball references. We don't really understand those around here.
But, I just think that you put all the hard work in it and the guys are doing the work. And, at some point, it's going to turn in your favor. And it did tonight. We did a great job. And I'm excited about our football team.
Hey, great job, Russell Wilson. He did it.
He did it.
I got to be honest. You got to give Coach Tomlin some credit, too, right? Like, the offense. Yeah,
clapping for that, too.
You sort of do, man. You sort of do, right? All right. I don't know. Good game for Russell Wilson.
Yeah.
Solid, man.
Yeah.
It's good to have two quarterbacks. I think that's how you look at it. And it's same way Coach Tomlin, I think, was looking at it. Like, hey, we haven't even started AFC North football yet.
Uh-huh.
Like, I'm not going
long
into
way
AFC
to go.
North football.
Long way to go.
Not knowing what Russ can do. So I still think this is a let's see who we want moving forward. But again, it's the NFL. Sometimes injuries and sometimes bad play sorts itself out.
That's only the first taste of Russell Wilson, though.
Yeah.
Like, they're not even comfortable with each other out there yet.
Yeah.
You know?
Next game for the Steelers is coming up in a week. Monday Night Football, they play the 2-5 Giants. Oh, man. Games like that always scare me. But the Giants do stink, though, so we should be able to win that game. And the Steelers will find out tonight as the Ravens play Monday Night Football tonight whether or not they are alone atop the AFC North or they're tied with the Ravens. All right, let's get to another talkback message here. Send them through the free iHeartRadio app. Talkback messages brought to us by the Pavement Group.
Did you guys see that Michael Keaton intro to the Steelers game? Pittsburgh Steelers!
Yep, that's how I felt too.
Uh-huh.
Yep, like you're already excited for the game before the opening kickoff even takes place. It was the explosion. Michael Keaton, of course, famous actor, Batman and that.
Just talking so sexy about the Steelers in the city.
Oh, man. Oh. Okay, do we need it? Okay.
Listen, when you're from where I'm from, Western PA, just outside of Pittsburgh.
I'm already all in. That's all I need.
The Steelers are like a local religion in a way, where everyone goes to the same church. Your family, your friends, the guys at the gas station, the Steelers unite us all. So here I am. I've been a fan my entire life, and every frickin' Sunday in the fall, I'm still watching this team.
By the way, did Batman just pull out his credentials like a Facebook comment there?
He did. Let him cook. He's good.
Okay.
He's
good.
Look at all the terrible towels waving. Thousands of them.
Now, whether it's this kid Fields.
And Fields will score.
Or Russ.
Doesn't matter, right?
I'm good either way.
Oh, Batman's good either way.
Mike T has got these guys playing the right way like he always does.
Oh, playing
Steeler
the
way.
Playing the right way.
Now tonight.
Come on, Batman.
The circus comes to town. And I don't mean to demean any new acquisitions.
Congratulations, Devontae Adams.
Yeah, Devontae Adams, what a time he's had. The Jets wide receiver who they just traded for because he used to play for Aaron Rodgers. And he was with the Raiders. The Raiders lost to the Steelers, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then he gets traded to a new team. Then he loses to the Steelers again. Devontae Adams probably had enough Pittsburgh at this point, I would think.
I think I can say with authority that all is not right in Gotham.
A lot of drama, a lot on the line.
You do realize the Steelers have had 3 coaches in 55 years.
Don't tell us, Batman.
And the Jets have got, like, what, 2 in the last 2 weeks?
Oh, man, Batman, boom. He's just taking a flamethrower to the Jets.
No disrespect, I just feel like you should know these things if you're going to watch this game. And appreciate what football means to people in those things. I guess my point is, there aren't enough things that unite us anymore. Come to Pittsburgh. You'll see how great it is when something does that. That's really all I wanted to say.
Oh, my God.
Enjoy the game.
What are you doing?
Oh, my God.
What are you doing? What are you doing over there?
Michael Keaton got my nipples hard. Okay. Oh, my God.
I did not expect that to be a line on the show today. Michael Keaton. Dude, the end he's just like, hey, there's not a lot of things that bring us together anymore as a country.
Pittsburgh.
Come to Pittsburgh and watch football.
You'll see how great it is when something does that. Ooh. That's really all I wanted to say.
Oh.
Enjoy the game.
Ding.
Rock hard nipples.
All right. Michael Keaton talking the intro of Sunday Night Football.
Man.
Then the Steelers go on to beat the Jets 37-15. You know what? I'm going to play it because this is almost too much Pittsburgh to even take right here. It's the explosion.
Warning. There is an overload of awesome Pittsburgh on the show right now.
Batman!
Oh, man.
Pittsburgh!
Too much. Overload.
Pittsburgh!
Explosion.
Monday is kind of nice. After a win like that, the Steelers with a convincing win over the Jets Sunday Night Football last night, 37-15 at Acrisure. Now let's get to Coach Tomlin. He, of course, was giving his press conference after the game. And you know what we like to do here? We like to slow Coach Tomlin down and make him sort of sensual after the game. So here was Coach Tomlin after the game talking about the Steelers' performance.
I'm talking football at Acrisure, man. I'm just really appreciative of the atmosphere and the quality of play. Hopefully there's growth in this as we move forward, man. But it's good to get a win.
He still needs to put the R in Acrisure. He always Acrisures
it, doesn't nail it.
I think he's doing it on purpose because he knows it's Heinz Field, right? Like, I think he's doing it on purpose. Then Coach Tomlin was asked, you know, just talk about the play of Beanie Bishop. I told everybody.
You did. You really did.
told everybody in camp, watch Beanie Bishop, undrafted rookie. Didn't think Beanie Bishop would be this. Two interceptions, like kind of game-changing interceptions against a sure Hall of Famer in the future, Aaron Rodgers. Here was Coach Tomlin talking about the efforts of Beanie Bishop after the game.
Can't say enough about young Beanie Bishop, man. That's an awesome evening, man, for him to get his first two interceptions versus a gold jacket guy like Aaron Rodgers. He's on a good trajectory.
Oh, man. Two is better than one.
Ho! Yeah, Beanie Bishop told everybody to watch him in camp.
Young Beans.
Here he is. Two interceptions off Aaron Rodgers. Man, I just loved the special teams so much last night. Like, the special teams just blocking kicks. And, yeah, oh, yeah, man. Yeah, yeah.
The celebration.
Oh, man. Dude, at one point, Danny Smith was, like, trending on X or Twitter or whatever, and I'm like, man, this is the feeling right here. This is the feeling. Here was Coach Tomlin, of course, talking about the performance of Russell Wilson.
I thought he was excellent. It's been a while since he's played some ball. He settled in, knocked the rust off, man, and distributed the ball around and played well.
Knock the rust off Russ.
Ooh. Ho, ho.
Smooth, Coach Tomlin.
Gave him the rusty Russ.
I don't think we gave them the rusty Russ.
I think we did.
No, Russ. All right, maybe first half, rusty Russ. But then they got the full Russ. What are we talking about? Rusty Russ. All right. Let me just get this one out with no sensual Tomlin. This is just how it sounded when he was asked back-to-back questions about, you know, Justin Fields. Did you ever consider putting him in for
sure,
maybe a short yardage? Mm-hmm. And then the Russell Wilson one-yard touchdown run.
Did you consider using Justin at all in any of those short yardage opportunities?
I did not.
Nope. Do you think about putting in Justin for short yardage? Nope.
What does it say that Russ kept the ball and pushed his way in for that one-yard rushing touchdown? And what did you learn about maybe his resilience and his strength in that moment?
It was just a sneak.
Just a sneak.
That's all it was.
Like, I love how sometimes, like, the reporters and people who cover the team can almost think about and overanalyze it too much. Just like, what did it say about Russ and his resiliency? And he's just like, just sneak. Just quarterback sneak.
That's like, all it was.
Didn't really think about it too much. So, man, that was a great win for the Steelers.
It was.
And we all watch Monday Night Football tonight to see if the Ravens win or lose. The Ravens will be taking on the Buccaneers, and Chargers-Cardinals is the other game. But we are all Buccaneers fans tonight. Huge win for the Steelers. That might have been one of the best performances of the year so far. Hey, good for Coach Tomlin. He wanted to see if Russell Wilson still had a little bit left in him. And it looks like Russell Wilson is a capable starting quarterback in the NFL.
He still got it. Still got
it. Like, I don't even know if this needs to be a Russ versus Justin thing. Like, I think we're going to need both of them to make a deep playoff run. I don't think they're both going to be healthy all year, and I just don't think it – you know, it's almost like in hockey, and I've been saying this, you're probably going to need a backup goalie at some point. So it looks like we have two capable starting quarterbacks. And I know people go, oh, if you have two quarterbacks, you don't have one. I don't know. Seems to be okay.
Seems all right now. Yeah.
Big win for the Steelers, though. Russell Wilson in his first game as a Steeler threw for 264 yards, two touchdowns, no interception, even had a one-yard touchdown run. The running game, man, Naj was over 100 yards. He had 102 yards. Jalen Warren.
Nasty runs, too.
44 yards. They had 149 yards on 36 carries for the Steelers' running game. And then George Pickens, he got involved in the offense. Five catches, 111 yards in his first touchdown of the season. And really, one of the standouts of the game, Beanie Bishop, the undrafted rookie defensive back from West Virginia, picked off future Hall of Famer Aaron Rodgers twice in the game. That's pretty awesome game there for Beanie Bishop. Now let's get to Russell Wilson, because I was ready to hear what Russell Wilson had to say after the game as far as what his tagline would be, because he had a couple different taglines over the years. You know, when he was with the Broncos, it was "Let's ride," and he would say it after
everything.
Yes. Even when he was at the podium. So this was Russell Wilson on the field with Melissa Stark after the game, talking about the win.
We're excited, man. Just another win, you know. And, you know, I also want to give credit to Justin, man, how he got us in this position. What a great player he is. Just this whole team, I really love it. Just really love being here. And,
yeah.
You know, shout out to C and the kids up there. I don't know if they're still here or not. It's late. But, man, I'm just grateful, man. God gave me an opportunity.
And we know you've had your catchphrases in Seattle and in Denver. You want to sign us off with your latest one?
We'll just wait. We'll wait till the end. We'll see what happens.
Huh? Wait till the end of what?
We'll wait till the end.
Okay. Yeah. All right. We got to wait. The suspense, the drama.
Yeah, you know what? Melissa Stark's right. Wait till the end of what?
She's like, game's over.
So I thought then, okay, he doesn't do this on the field in his post-game interview.
Right, yeah, yeah.
He's going to do it at the press conference
make a thing out of it,
yeah.
Right?
No, he didn't. I thought when he was at the microphone
not even a mention.
No, there's no Steeler Nation, let's ride. There's no, wasn't he supposed to do let's get number seven,
yeah,
or
something
like that? Something
about number seven.
About number seven he was supposed to say? Like, what's he doing, man? Russ!
We're waiting.
You just cooked a little bit. That's
Strip District's waiting to print shirts.
Seriously, the whole strip.
There's an economy waiting on you.
Yinzers in the Strip is waiting by their printing press for you to just say the words so they can put a number three Wilson on
the
back of
the
shirt.
The thing.
You gotta say the catchphrase, man. So he didn't say the thing?
No, he didn't say anything. Right. No. Yeah.
Russell Wilson, listen, I know it's your first game back. We're going to need a catchphrase.
Maybe he's working on it still.
We're going to need something that you say at the end of every interview that annoys the living hell out of every other fan base. Because I know when he did it before, I'd just be like, why does he do that? That's weird.
Right, just like you.
Yeah, but hey, if he says,
do it for us.
If he tells me Stairway to Seven continues or something at the end of every Russell Wilson press conference or interview, then I'm all in, you know. Print it.
Gotta say the thing.
Gotta say the thing. The entire Strip District economy depends on it, Russell Wilson. I know you might not know about that yet. You're still kind of new here, but
the Yinz economy.
Come on,
Russ.
The Yinz economy of printing sayings on shirts needs you, Russell Wilson. Najee Harris over 100 yards once again. Here was Najee after the game, talking about the Steelers' offensive line.
Yeah, man, the O line did really good, man. All 11 of them, man, they did good, man. And this is the outcome that happens, though, man. We're not surprised. I'm not surprised on it, man. They all have it in them. Just going out there and executing it is always just the main thing. And today, I think that they did that. You know, all four quarters. That's what we always talked about. That, you know, they got a good defense, some good players. But you know, we felt that we could take it to them and finish in the fourth. And I think that showed.
Yeah, Naj was just talking
Naj
about.
Naj knows.
He knows it was special.
Naj knows he's cooking. I mean, that's two games in a row. It's like 100 yards.
I know. And that's exactly what we need for whatever quarterback's in there, Russ or Justin Fields, you know, especially to give Russ more time, I think, in the pocket since he can't escape like Justin Fields. Just having a run game like Naj back-to-back 100-yard games really helps out. Here was Naj just talking about the better overall offensive performance from the team with Russ in there.
Yeah, man, that's good, man, because that's what you want to see. To see GP get in the end zone, you see Russ in there getting the end zone, man, just to see all the O-line meshing in, and, you know, they're out there talking too, man, and they're out there, you know, holding each other accountable. That's the main thing, man. They was out there holding each other accountable. Man, just the O-line, I think that this game, the O-line should be more talked about because, you know, we're down injuries, we're down guys. It's the next man mentality, and somebody always steps up and performs and makes a play. So, man, I think that the O-line, going in 2 weeks now, I think me personally, I had like 100 yards, and I think that, you know, it's all dedicated to them and giving me opportunities. So, man, shout out to them.
Nah, just like, I've always been this way. You give me a couple holes, you see what I can do here. All right, let's get to George Pickens after the game talking about Russell Wilson.
A guy going to back-to-back Super Bowls, you know, he knows when guys are blitzing. His cadence is a little more dominant with guys jumping off sides, you know what I mean? But like I said, on third down and second down, they play a lot of man-on-man, and we took opportunities.
And then George Pickens talking about his touchdown catch there.
Yeah, it felt good. It felt super good. I'll probably just say, man-on-man, you know, man-on-man suggestions with their DBs. You know, a lot of DBs they had were hurt. Like I said, as soon as we seen the guys at the end, we took opportunity for sure.
Yeah, he's like, yeah, they had a couple people in their secondary hurt. And basically I just said, okay, Russ, let's eat.
Man, so, everybody's happy.
I know. Everybody is happy.
Everybody's happy.
Tomlin's happy. Like, quarterback's happy. Justin Fields, I feel like, is happy.
Waking up on a Monday just feeling good.
It does. It does feel good. And then, you know, the next game, you're playing a 2-5 Giants team coming in here. And I know we don't take any game for granted with the Steelers because they always seem to lose games like that. Maybe it's just a little bit different. But last night felt really good. That's a good defense. That's a great defense they were playing, too.
Yeah, yeah, they are.
They scored 37 points on a damn good defense. Like, they had a couple players that were missing, yeah, but, like, that the Jets have a good defense this year. 37 points, and the Steelers get the win 37-15. And then we read the Facebook comments.
Beware. We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet. Everyone is a GM. Everyone is a coach. Everyone is going to get traded. Everything sucks. It's time for Steelers Facebook comments.
Steelers Facebook comments after they beat the Jets 37-15.
Big win.
It was a big win. Yeah, I don't know. I honestly don't know how these Facebook comments are going to go. Chris E. here, after years and years of absolute misery, I'm finally excited. Let's go, Steelers. Wow. Whoa.
Here we go.
Hank S., this is my Steeler team that I used to know. Bob M., looking like our old Pittsburgh Steelers, a breath of fresh air.
Wow.
Justin H., my moment of the night was seeing the special teams guys rush Danny Smith, the special teams coach, who is the mortal enemy of chewing gum. Man, are these all positive?
Hey, that
here?
Was awesome. Hey, that guy's right.
I know.
Awesome.
That was the point where I was just smiling
drunk
to myself.
Off
just
football.
Go, ah, man. Yes, drunk off Steeler football at that moment. Lynn D., I'm with Wilson. I'm with Fields. I'm with the Steelers. Let's go, Steeler Nation.
Look at
oh,
these
my
comments.
Gosh, positive. Sean E. here. I am not excited.
What?
All right, here we go.
Oh, no.
It's going to have to turn at some point. The Steelers and Tomlin will still blow this season. Jets are a 2-5 team with no coach, a washed-up quarterback, and a defense missing a lot of starters. I'm not impressed.
Always a Debbie Downer.
If it's down, we need to bring it back up then, right?
Yeah.
With Jack S. here in the Facebook comments, these block number jerseys do something to me like a Yinzer Viagra. And we're back up.
Is that Yinzer Viagra?
The block letter jerseys? with the gray face mask, yes. Yinzer Viagra.
That's dangerous to give it to 60,000 people in the stands at one time and millions watching at home.
It is. It's a lot of Yinzer Viagra to pass out there. All right. It is Steelers Facebook comments after they beat the Jets 37-15. Don G here. Oh, man. I have trouble with people named Don G.
Don?
Stops me every time, man. It's like I can't be,
you want to read it as Dong, don't you?
I can't be mature enough to just say Don G in the Facebook comments.
Don
always,
G here.
Everyone all excited. I guess they forgot we have the worst coach in the league and we'll mess this season up. All right, Dong, get out of here, Dong.
Dong just needs a little Steeler Viagra. Look at those jerseys. Look at those jerseys, Don G.
Give Steelers Viagra to Don G. Michael S. here in the Steelers Facebook comments. Russell Wilson has big balls of steel. He's going to lead us to the Super Bowl. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, Michael. Daniel R., Steeler Nation. I take back everything I said about Russ being washed and immobile. Bill T., all you boo bums. Take it back. I was there. And I was yelling at the boo bums booing our team. You want to do that crap? Go to a Pirate game and get the hell out of my stadium. You kicking the boo bums
out
of this?
Yeah, yeah, the booing fans are gone.
I thought they were boo birds, not boo bums.
In that guy's world, they're bums.
Okay. Oh, damn! Get him out of here!
Get out!
If you booed at any point during the game!
Take Dong with you!
My Miss Boo Bums and my Miss Boo Bums. Couple more. Tony B. Anyone ask Devontae Adams what it's like to lose to the same team in back-to-back weeks? Donald G. here. Oh, my God. No way. Donald.
Another double dong. Are you special round of comments?
Are you personalizing
these names? I did not.
Donald G here. Pittsburgh is going to the Super Bowl with that big bad D. All right, Donald G, we don't need that one out of you.
Calm down, Don G.
Let's go with Doug L here. I think Tomlin's a jag-off, but that second half is the best the Steelers have looked since the early years of Big Ben. Oh, my God.
Wow, early Ben.
If we got a Yinzer like
An
that.
Early Ben.
Wow.
Woo!
Douglas A. in the Steelers Facebook comments, let's hope we get second half Russ and not the pants pooper that started the game for us. Did Russ mess his pants in the
little bit? Is that what he had to get through? Was he playing through a poop?
Ed F. here. I grilled up some Wilson wieners on the grill tonight before the game.
Chef Ed, grilling weenies?
Thick quarter pound hot dogs.
Oh, okay.
Chili cheese.
Oh, we're getting the recipe.
Yellow mustard. And a drizzle of hot honey.
Oh, man.
Look what happened. 37 points. The highest all year.
Wilson weenies for everyone.
Thank you, Ed.
Thank you, Chef Ed.
Thank you, Ed, for the Wilson weenies. Diego C. here. The defense kicks your ass. The offense kicks your face. And Boswell kicks those balls into outer space. One more. Ben Y. I am riding the Russ the rest of the season. Everybody hop on the Russ. Let's ride.
Are we riding the Russ?
Not you, Don G. You stay out of this. let me get the final countdown tango version here for Russ. Russell Wilson talking after the game about, you know, when the team called him and why this was the spot for him.
I thank all the people, you know, that have helped me along the way. Just even transitioning here. Just coming to an amazing place. When Coach Tomlin called me and Omar, I knew it was here.
Yeah,
hell yeah.
When I talked to Cam Hayward and TJ Watt and Minka, you know, I knew it was here. You know, the men that we have in that locker room, the time that we share together in Latrobe, even though I was down and out for a little bit there, just sitting on the back porch and talking life, talking ball, talking moments, all that.
Sitting on the porch,
bonding,
talking life, talking ball. Yeah. Hell yeah! It's where the seeds were made. And now this Russ flower has sprouted up. Here was Russ just talking about how the team is getting better, not just on offense, defense too.
I feel like we have this young offense, young players that are so talented, and we're just like we're right on that edge of getting really good. We got to keep searching for that edge. We got to keep. You know, learning, you know, and studying. And
take me to the edge, Russ. Can you show us the edge? A lot of these guys have never been to the edge, Russ. Take us to the edge.
And spending the time on it. And you know, we get to go against our defense every day, who's the top of the game. You know, you get to see guys like TJ Watt and Cam and Minka, and just we're all learning and watching, you know, Alex and just these guys just
talking ball on the porch.
PQ and E-Rob and those guys, just the edge that they play with and they come to work with.
Take us to the edge.
Tell me about the D.
For us as well as on the offensive side, we get to see that. We get to experience that. We get to be that too. And we have that in our locker room. You know, part of my job, I believe, you know, sitting here in 13 years in the game is to make sure I take guys to that edge.
Take me to the edge.
The leader.
I've never been there before.
The leader.
I want to go right. I want to go to the edge. Take me to the edge, Russell Wilson.
You're not ready for the edge.
I don't think I am.
You're not ready for the edge.
I don't think I was even born to go close to the edge. I get nervous whenever I get close to the edge and I can fall. You know, like, I don't like edges.
I don't trust them, man.
Russell Wilson's taking me to the edge, though.
Yeah, hold my hand, Russ. Walk me to the edge.
Russell Wilson's take me to the edge. Hey, I'm ready. I'm kind of falling apart here. I didn't sleep a lot last night, to be honest with you. Here's your chance to win $1,000. Good luck. Right now, let's get some of your talkback messages. You can send them through the free iHeartRadio app. Talkback messages brought to us by One Team Media.
Hey, guys. It was a great game last night.
Yeah.
Mikey, you mentioned that you chuckled to yourself after the special team celebration.
Yeah, Danny Smith with just so much gum in his mouth and the players just going nuts after that block kick.
I got to admit, I chuckled to myself after Beanie Bishop's second interception. Chris Collinsworth used the opportunity to share with the world about his airport Beanie Baby collection.
Yeah, it was kind of weird, but, you know. Beanie Bishop, I told everybody. Told everybody in training
camp.
He was
on the list, man.
You got to watch Beanie Bishop. Watch Beanie Bishop. Now Collinsworth's talking about
Beanie Babies.
Weird random Beanie Babies that he collects at the airport. Yeah, that was part of the game last night.
Like Collinsworth had no other connection here. Beanie, and she's like, I used to buy
this
Beanie Babies.
His name is Beanie.
Beanie Babies at the airport.
All right, let's get to another talkback message here.
Good morning, goalpost and Gatorade cooler. This is Miss Coach Putney from Tampa, and I was driving to school. And on the iHeartRadio app, it was talking about a clip from the show with six nipples on a badger.
Yeah.
It made me think of last night when they were introing Russell Wilson and he said his name. He said he was from a school full of badgers.
Whoa.
I don't know if anyone else caught that, but I was on an airplane and was laughing hysterically.
Whoa.
Let's go Steelers.
Whoa, hold on. She might have found the connection here to the stairway. This might unlock the stairway to seven. Russell Wilson played at Wisconsin.
Yeah.
They're the Badgers.
Yes.
Also, let me play this quick little thing that we play on the show all the time.
96.1 KISS.
The Mikey and Bob Podcast.
Google it right now. How many nipples does a badger have?
Six.
Six rings. Six nipples on a badger.
Steelers.
Here we go.
Stream the Mikey and Bob podcast on iHeartRadio or wherever you get your podcasts.
Wow. We got Beanie Bishop picking off Aaron Rodgers two times. Mm-hmm. Chris Collinsworth talking about collecting Beanie Babies at the airport.
Got a six-nippled badger.
Russell Wilson. You know, a lot of people just call him Russ. His real nickname that might need to be put on a shirt in the Strip District is Russell Wilson, the six-nipple badger. Is he the six-nipple badger that's going to take us to seven? Oh, my gosh.
I just picture a horrible Photoshop of Russell Wilson's head on a badger laid out with six nipples on it.
We have people who are very good at art and cartoons who are probably going to make that for us later.
Six-nippled Russell Wilson.
But then what do I do with it? If somebody sends me six-nippled Russell, like, what do I do with that? Like, half badger, half Russell Wilson? Like, what am I supposed to do with that? Except print it out and frame it and put it on the hallway next to DVD and see if anybody notices.